subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Home to numerous religions, ancient temples, tribes, and an array of sacred places, Odisha observes many fairs and festivals throughout the year. The three-day-long Raja festival, celebrated in the mid of June, is one among them. Adding the bright colors to the landscapes of Odisha, this festival commemorates the fertility of Mother Earth and womanhood. Though the occasion is observed amid huge fanfare every year, but this year, due to coronavirus outbreak, audience preferred to celebrate it in solitude. Have a look.
Just one swing, that too having a dummy of a masked girl sitting on it. This was the scene at Odisha's capital Bhubaneswar during the recently observed Raja festival. The most important carnival in Odisha that celebrates womanhood and menstruation was very low-spirited this time amid coronavirus pandemic, as people across the country are asked to follow the social distancing rules and avoid any huge gathering. But even in this precarious situation, the Odisha Tourism Development Corporation, OTDC, came up with a unique initiative of Pitha on Wheels and home delivery that will help people celebrate the occasion in their homes while keeping corona at bay. Pitha, a traditional delicacy which is savoured during the Raja festival, was delivered to people at their homes.
भेजते हैं हम बाइक में भेजते हैं हमारे जो हमारा जो स्टाफ है वो लेके आठ बजे को टेलीफोन में ऑर्डर रखते हैं उसको होम डिलीवर करके पैसा लाते हैं
जनरली पीपल ऑफ ओडिशा दे लव द कल्चर दे यूज टू सेलिब्रेट डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ फेस्टिवल्स एंड दे लास्ट बट नॉट द लिस्ट दे आर वेरी मच फूडी एंड रजो इज ए फेस्टिवल इट्स ए फेस्टिवल ऑफ पेइंग ट्रिब्यूट टू मदरहुड एंड द मदर अर्थ Generally, the people of Odisha used to celebrate Raja for 3 days and they used to celebrate it in a high scale. But due to the lockdown and the weekend shutdown, this time the Raja has come up with a low key. And OTDC Panthanivas has introduced pitha on wheel and home delivery or takeaway pitha for first of its kind.
Besides, several counters were also opened at various cities of Odisha like Bhubaneswar, Cuttack, Sambalpur and Rourkela for selling pithas. People were allowed to buy them from the counters provided they wear masks and adhere to social distancing norms. For making and selling these pithas, OTDC gave opportunity to several women self-help groups in the state.
For the first time, we have tagged some SHG self-help group women and their product also. Basically, we are keeping focus on millets product, which is very much hygienic and useful for our immune system. And around 100 women of self-help group are helping us.
Raja Festival celebrates the spirit of womanhood and is of utmost importance to women who pamper themselves by wearing new dresses and getting decked up with fashionable accessories. During the 3 days, women take a break from all household work and spend the entire day having fun on rope swings, playing indoor and outdoor games, singing folk songs and eating scrumptious food. It is believed that Mother Earth menstruates for these days and hence she is given a ceremonial bath on the fourth day. As a mark of respect towards the earth, during her menstruation days, all agriculture activities like plowing, sowing is suspended for the 3 days as Mother Earth is expected to be going through rejuvenation. Harmonious coexistence and regards for other religions is an integral part of Indian ethos, and as a result, examples of communal harmony can be witnessed in every nook and corner of the country. One such example was witnessed in Mandsaur village of Madhya Pradesh, where in an effort to contain coronavirus, a Muslim man developed a contact lens sensor bell for a Hindu temple in the state.
With the lifting of COVID-19 restrictions, as many temples have reopened across various parts of the country and devotees have started thronging them on a regular basis, it's important to take extra precautionary measures as these holy sites to avoid the virus spread. One such effort has been made at the Shiva temple in Mandsaur, where a bell with a sensor has been installed which can ring without the need for physically touching it. But what makes this innovation unique is a feeling of communal harmony that it promotes, as it has been developed by a 62-year-old mechanic, Nehru Khan, who worked around the clock to make such a creative device. Moreover, the fact that drove him towards this innovation is that azans are happening at mosque, but the Shiva temple is left bereft of the resonance of bell.
जब से कोरोना महामारी का चालू हुआ, लॉकडाउन हुआ, जब से ही घंटी के कोई छूना बिल्कुल नहीं, कोई हाथ नहीं लगाए, इसलिए बंद थी। मैंने सोचा कि क्यों ना दरबार की घंटी बजे, ताकि हम अजान होती है, हमारी अजान भी हम सुनते हैं, तो दरबार की घंटी भी सुने, वो भी बजना चाहिए, ताकि जल्दी से जल्दी कोरोना समाप्त हो। और मैंने ऐसा सेंसर द्वारा ऐसे मैंने सेंसर पर, आप खाली हाथ रखो, छूना नहीं उसको, बगैर छुए घंटी बज जाती है।
The bell made by Khan starts ringing as soon as the devotee comes under it or falls his hands beneath it to pay respect to the deity. With this innovation, the Shiva temple has become the only temple in Madhya Pradesh, perhaps in the country, to have a bell fitted with sensor. Recently, Khan was also honored by the Hindu people in the area for giving his unique creation to the temple.
Corona jis tarah se chhune se phail raha hai, to ek dar hai sabke hi mann mein ke kuch ghanti aur mandir jaate, ghanta bajate, to usse bhi phail sakta hai. To uske nijaat ke liye ek sensor ke through bina chhue ghanta bajta hai.
This is not for the first time that Khan has set such an example of religious brotherhood. In the past, he has donated soundless power generators to temples, including the Shiva temple and Nalcha Mata temple, both in Mandsaur district.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Before the coronavirus hit New Delhi, Mohammad Amir Khan was a taxi driver making a living in the national capital. But after work dried up during a nearly three-month lockdown to prevent the spread of the virus, a friend suggested he take on a part-time job at perhaps the only booming business in the country, driving a private ambulance. On his first day, without any training, he was ferrying patients to a hospital for his firm, a private contractor brought in to deal with a surge in the number of patients. A week later, his ambulance became a hearse transporting corpses to cremation ghats and cemeteries, sometimes stacked on top of each other, six at one time.
काम धंधे सब बंद हुए पड़े हैं, हर आदमी परेशान है, तो कुछ तो करना पड़ेगा। इस बार समाज सेवा भी हो जाएगी हमारी, किसी को तो आगे आना पड़ेगा सर, क्या समझे।
A combination of wearing a mandatory PPE kit while driving an ambulance full of COVID-19 bodies under the oppressive summer heat has made working a massive health challenge for Khan.
Wedding halls in New Delhi have been turned into quarantine centers to treat patients infected with the coronavirus as the number of cases continues to mount in the national capital. With the numbers rising rapidly and hospitals running out of beds in New Delhi, a need to have more beds for COVID-19 patients has become important.
यहाँ पर जैसे ये पहले लॉज था, इसको क्वारंटीन में तब्दील कर दिया गया है लोगों के इलाज के लिए, ट्रीटमेंट के लिए।
ग्रीन लाउंज बैंकेट्स एंड यूफोरिया बैंकेट्स आर सम ऑफ द वेडिंग हॉल्स व्हिच वर क्लोज्ड अर्लियर ड्यू टू कोरोनावायरस लॉकडाउन बट आर नाउ ओपन एंड विल हैव द कैपेसिटी टू अकोमोडेट अराउंड 100 पेशेंट्स।
A sweet shop in Kolkata city is selling immunity sandesh, special sweets prepared with medicinal properties in a bid to boost immunity against the fast-spreading coronavirus. The sandesh at the sweet shop is made using 15 different Indian herbs and spices with immunity-boosting properties.
We thought, why not to offer something extraordinary to our customers, to the society, and thus we made this sandesh. This sandesh is not only we are selling a sandesh, we are selling an idea. We are selling an idea to attract people towards these Indian spices so that they can have them regularly and boost their immunity.
As per the shop owner, the response of the customers is overwhelming, and people of every generation love these sweets, and it is selling like hot cake and has become the highest selling product.
A textile mill in Coimbatore city of Tamil Nadu is producing antiviral fabric that will be used to make masks to fight the coronavirus pandemic that has infected more than 3 lakh people in the country. With the number of cases of coronavirus rising each day in the country, more and more number of people are wearing masks to protect themselves from getting infected with the virus. Various companies across the country are coming up with new and innovative ideas to give better protection to the people.
This product has been tested by HIKE internationally on the SARS-CoV-2 virus, which is the current virus that is having this pandemic. It's very important because what might work on some viruses might not work on this particular virus. So this chemical has been treated, and that is why we chose it. Second, the chemical has a very unique characteristic. It's a very proprietary technology where the deactivation time on the virus is sub 3 minutes.
The fabric that has been made using Switzerland-based technology called Viroblock, that is a treatment made on fabric, is capable of killing or deactivating the virus within 3 minutes when it comes in contact with the cloth.
India resumed border trade with Bangladesh through the Petrapol integrated checkpost at Eastern West Bengal state's Fulbari border after 2 months of coronavirus lockdown. Anxious to revive the economy after a nearly 70-day lockdown, the government this week opened most public transport, offices and malls, even though health officials said the country was weeks away from flattening the curve of infections. The countries had halted transportation and sealed their borders to prevent this rise in the number of coronavirus cases that has infected over 7.4 million people across the world. Trucks loaded with goods and stones were seen crossing the border.
आज तो हम लोग का बहुत खुशी का दिन है क्योंकि आज हमारा बॉर्डर ओपन हुआ लॉकडाउन को अंदर में पूरा बंद था उसमें बहुत मतलब आर्थिक क्षति हुआ.
India shares 4,096 kilometers of border with Bangladesh, of which West Bengal has the most of 2,216 kilometers. The North Bengal frontier has a border of 1,070 kilometers of border with the country and has a number of porous areas. The two countries have struggled to establish good ties ever since India helped its eastern neighbor to emerge as independent Bangladesh in 1971 from what was then East Pakistan.
Service to humanity is service to God. Presently, when coronavirus has given a huge blow to humanity, several individuals and organizations across India are coming forward to feed a number of hungry souls, irrespective of their caste and community. A similar scene can be observed in Ranchi city, where policemen have taken the initiative to feed the hungry and help them survive amid the crisis. Have a look.
Among a number of individuals and organizations that have stepped up amid the global pandemic to help the needy and feed the hungry, names of our armed forces cannot go unmentioned. In Ranchi city of Jharkhand, the policemen have taken it on themselves to feed the hungry souls. Since 24th March, they have been regularly preparing 2 meals a day and serving it to the needy people, no matter which caste or community they belong to.
ये हम 24 तारीख से मार्च से हम लोग खाना खिला रहे हैं और ये दो दो बार दिन में खाना खिलाते हैं जी.
औसतन दिन में कितने लोग खाते हैं?
अभी औसत घट गया है लोगों का क्योंकि स्टैंड जो मजदूर जो फंसे हुए थे वो चले गए हैं तो अभी हमारा लगभग 500 से 600 दो टाइम मिला के लोग खाते हैं 600-700 कभी इसी हिसाब से.
A small tent with few tables and chairs has also been erected near the police station for the people to sit and have their meal in peace. People are effusive in their praise for the policemen for providing them with food at the time of need.
हम बहुत अच्छा है यहाँ पर इससे ये है कि हम लोग जितना भी मदद कर रहे हैं भाई लोग भी सहयोग करना चाहिए लेकिन हम लोग जितना भी है हम लोग बड़ा बाबू या क्या है हम लोग के लिए अच्छा आदमी है इतना मदद कर दे रहे हैं वो अच्छा है सबको खिलाते हैं बिठा के खिलाते हैं कि क्या भैया खाइए.
At present, when the whole country is reeling due to coronavirus, such an effort by our armed forces is really commendable. But along with them, there are many other individuals across the country who, rising above religious lines, are coming forward to help the needy amid the pandemic.
As the world is battling the deadly coronavirus, creative minds have been sparring up in every nook and corner of the country to come up with ideas that are emitting positivity and hope in tough times like these. A number of artists have come up from various parts of the country and showcased their creativity and skills. One amongst them is a brother-sister duo from the southern city of Chennai who have turned their house into a delightful place for art lovers during then nationwide lockdown. Have a look.
Scrap bottles, plants and a set of acrylic paint. This is all one needs to create masterpieces while staying at home. A brother-sister duo in the southern city of Chennai is proving that creativity is a state of mind and not resources by making art masterpieces at their home, which is catching eyeballs and making rounds on social media. Vedisha and Tabresh Iyer decided to use their lockdown days to create pieces of art and crafts.
I asked my brother, can I do painting in my wall? Then he said, just try in bottles. Then I asked him to bring bottles for my work. Then I started doing bottle works. Then it came very well. Then I started to do many bottles from my lockdown starting.
Looking beyond the gloom of the worldwide pandemic, Tabresh and Vedisha decided to bring out the hidden artist in themselves along with utilizing their spare time during the lockdown. While Tabresh, an engineering student, used his skills to paint murals, his sister Vedisha painted liquor bottles to add a dash of color in life and turn the dull lockdown days upside down. Both of them together have painted a beautiful painting of Lord Krishna and Goddess Radha on their walls and have made decorative decor out of scrap bottles.
When the lockdown started at lockdown 1.0, I got frustrated at first. I was just watching TV, locked down inside the house and not let out by parents. Just roaming within the roof and chatting with friends.
One of the few positive byproducts of coronavirus and the subsequent lockdown was, many have seen this as a chance to try new things and learn new arts while sitting at home. A number of painters, artists and commoners have stepped up during the pandemic to spread awareness and pay tribute to COVID warriors by using their paint brushes and artistry.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@nin.com. I'm your host Shreya Savijay and it's goodbye from the entire production team.